Olana wako, tamitanya katango, lemanyi ye, tamitanya katango. Olana wergeta, tamitanya katango, lemanyi ye. Olana timijo, kebe kilini, yenye kilini, olana weri. Ipa seme u, chamakingeja, kibusa kitu, chapaka matimoni.
To achieve 50 years of successful humanitarian work and sustain livelihoods of many vulnerable communities is not just a job, but a calling. In those 50 years, the society has worked diligently to respond to humanitarian needs and in building resilience, especially in arid lands and among pastoral communities. Some of the activities the society undertook were aligned to livelihoods, water and sanitation, health, emergency response and management, and Global Fund, to name but a few.
The other major highlights of 2015 was, of course, the SAD responding to the terrorist attack in Garissa University, the Mandera terrorist attack, the disasters like floods that we had in the country in October, November last year, but also other challenges, epidemics like cholera, which affected almost 24 counties last year, and many more everyday challenges of responding to fires, to other smaller disasters across the country were some of the major highlights. But also I would say a major highlight would have been the completion of our 2010-2015 strategic plan and working on the new strategic plan that was approved at the end of last year by the board.
To launch the 50th anniversary celebrations, an event was held on the 8th of May 2015 at the Kenyatta International Convention Centre and attended by many partners and dignitaries led by the Kenya Red Cross Society patron, His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta, President of the Republic of Kenya. Awards were given to various recipients for their great contribution to the work of the Kenya Red Cross Society and for their humanitarian work towards alleviating human suffering. Various celebrations were also conducted in various branches at the county level.
I'm happy also we are celebrating our 50th anniversary, and we celebrate this great 50 years in the work done by the Kenya Red Cross Society. We have gone a quite big mileage. Different activities have taken places, and we have managed to publicize the activities of the Kenya Red Cross Society. Our membership in the branch and sub-county has increased tremendously. Also, through the branding, we are more visible.
The climax of the celebrations took place during the Red Cross Gala Luncheon on the 20th of November 2015. Kenya Red Cross Society was honored to have the First Lady, Her Excellency Mrs. Margaret Kenyatta, grace the luncheon, which also marked the close of the 50th anniversary celebrations. During the event, Her Excellency officially launched the Kenya Red Cross Disaster Fund, to which over 4 million Kenya shillings was raised from corporate donations. Kenya Red Cross Society also launched its History of Kenya Red Cross Society book, which gives a chronological account of the work and activities of the society since it was established as the British Red Cross in Kenya until today.
The Red Cross is a leading institution for responding and alleviating human suffering. To continue its noble mission, the society requires resources from donors, large and small, to enable it to continue its admirable mission, implementing global best practices in humanitarian work and community empowerment. Along with the valued support from donors and philanthropists, we as Kenyans should continue to support this essential work.
The coordination among the teams on the ground has been achieved with painstaking excellence. For instance, early this year, Kenya Red Cross Society and the Emergency Plus Medical Service carried out the first ever air evacuation of two patients critically injured during a grenade attack in Mandera. The plane, fully fitted with equipment and staff from E-Plus, transferred the two patients for specialized medical attention at the Kenyatta National Hospital. The air evacuation, a maiden voyage by E-Plus Air Ambulance, has been a long-standing goal of the Kenya Red Cross Society, to be an air ambulance provider in addition to the already existing ground ambulance services. Further, our training school now offers specialized training for emergency medical technicians and paramedics. This provides the much-needed workforce for E-Plus and the country at large, so as to deliver professional emergency medical services to the people of Kenya. Kenya Red Cross Society continues to be the leading humanitarian organization in Kenya and first responder in emergencies. The terrorist attack by an armed group at Garissa University College in April 2015 demonstrated our timely response. Our teams were first on the ground soon after the attack, working closely with other command structures within the government. Our E-Plus deployed ambulances and paramedics at the scene within 15 minutes of the attack and provided emergency healthcare and evacuation of casualties to the nearby Garissa General Hospital. In addition to emergency healthcare, Kenya Red Cross Society provided a team of counselors to provide psychological support, first aid, and tracing services to family members, friends, and relatives of the deceased and survivors. Kenya Red Cross Society was also proud to work closely with the government through the Office of the President to facilitate a number of youth dialogue platforms in various parts of the country. The dialogues were meant to provide a safe space for young people to articulate their concerns and provide solutions. Kenya Red Cross Society organized these platforms from the ward level all the way up to the regional level.
Kupitia ofisi yako, unaweza mheshimiwa rais kutusaidia na zile bomba za maji. Tuweze kusambaziwa maji na tukaweze kufanya hata kilimo cha irrigation. Kwa sababu nikisema hivyo tuweza ku address issue ya maji katika Taita Taveta County, tutaweza pia kuondoa au kupunguza mgogoro baina ya wanyamapori na binadamu.
Regarding the issue of education in our region, we also feel it is a great concern since we are having limited resources in our existing education facilities for higher learning, with only Technical University of Mombasa, which set a branch in Kwale County.
Really, the key and the objective is to say that we can find solutions. What we need to do is to talk to one another. And those solutions, as Abasa said, don't need to come from me. They can come from you, because you have the capacity to identify where the problems are, but also to offer solutions as to how we can deal with some of those issues.
With the country expecting to receive high volumes of rainfall after an alert was issued by the Kenya Meteorological Department, the Kenya Red Cross Society, in collaboration with the Kitui County Government, distributed maize seeds towards the El Nino emergency preparedness. A total of 67 households were targeted per constituency, with each household set to receive 2 kilograms of DH4 hybrid maize. Maize seed was distributed to over 21,000 farmers in Kitui County. An initial investment of 7 million shillings is expected to bring colossal returns of over 1 billion shillings. The El Nino Emergency Preparedness Maize Distribution is a clear example of using weather and scientific information to plan ahead, and most importantly, how we can address food security and economic empowerment.
Kwa hivyo tukipanda mbegu hizi kwa wakati ufao, tutaweza kupata mavuno yenye itatusaidia kupata chakula na kukaa kwa amani kwa maboma yetu, kwa sababu tukiwa na chakula na tukiweza kusomesha watoto wetu, tutakuwa na amani kama wamama na kama wazee, tutakuwa na amani.
To ensure that the community has sustained livelihood projects, the society commissioned various livelihood projects. Under the Water and Sanitation Program, Bomet and Tot Koloa were commissioned respectively. In Tot Koloa, 1,000 households were organized into 2 farming irrigation schemes of 500 members each and were trained on basic crop production techniques, irrigation farming, water management and leadership. A 500-acre farm was fully developed with sprinkler irrigation infrastructure. This project was designed to bring an end to the perennial hunger in the area by empowering residents to produce food and generate income on the vast land in Kerio Valley. This initiative was not only meant to provide food for the starving families, but also bring together Pokot and Marakwet communities that have been living acrimoniously. The Tot Koloa Drought Recovery Project has reached over 7,000 beneficiaries.
Tunaona maembe iko hapa, tunaona watermelon ziko hapa, banana ziko hapa, kumaanisha ya kwamba sehemu hii inaweza kuzalisha vyakula, tuondoe njaa na tuweke amani.
The Kinango Integrated Food Security Project was one of the highest sponsored projects by a local donor, the M-Pesa Foundation and the Kwale County Government. Kinango Integrated Food Security and Livelihoods Project contributes to the reduction of food insecurity in drought-stricken communities of Kinango Sub-County in Kwale County. Over 10,000 beneficiaries are targeted through enhanced food availability, access to safe water, sanitation, hygiene education, and nutrition awareness. The farmers have so far been able to harvest approximately 20 tons of spinach, 40 tons of watermelon, 20 tons of butternut, and 30 tons of onion. Over 1.2 million Kenya shillings has been generated so far from sales from this farm.
Wale wameona wamejua kwamba sasa hii mradi uko na manufaa haya. Wengi sasa wanakuja kwetu. Pia mimi nataka nipate mali, pia mimi nataka nipate mali. At least tukiwa tumepata kama watu kama 600, 800 hivi, wote watakuwa mashamba pale. Then hizi shida ndogo ndogo kama za watoto kutoenda skuli, afya na lishe bora, mpato la kawaida, tutakuwa tumepunguza.
In the health and nutrition sector, the society and the county government played a major role in ensuring those at risk can access health facilities. The Garbatula District Hospital Operating Theatre in Isiolo and the Maternal, Newborn and Child Health in West Pokot were commissioned to ensure community members can access the health facilities. The launch of the National Non-Communicable Diseases Strategic Plan also represents a major achievement in the prevention of NCDs and emphasizes the need for innovation in healthcare delivery. The Global Fund Program signed 7 grant agreements with implementing partners worth a total of $333 million to expand interventions for HIV, tuberculosis, and malaria in the effort to reach 1 million people with treatment for HIV by 2017.
I have 20 grants who are HIV positive. The training that we got from the Red Cross through the Global Fund in conjunction with the Hope Old World, it did help us reach so many grants, and it taught us how to train them on the way they can be able to take care of their own health and even their friends. They could help them, so one grant could help us reach another 2 or 3 grants.
With the aim of lifting the debate on leadership and governance within African national societies, the International Center for Humanitarian Affairs hosted Yves Dacour, the Director General of the International Committee of the Red Cross. He shared his insights with Kenya Red Cross staff about the future he foresees for the movement. ICHA also hosted several humanitarian speakers who engaged staff on the humanitarian principles.
In my view, a genuinely local actor should meet a number of criteria. One, it must come from the community. The community can be defined in many ways. A community can be a whole nation, a community can be a region, a community can be a village, depending on the scope of action. But whatever it is, it must come from genuinely from there.
The Boma Hotel, which is fully owned by Kenya Red Cross Society, has further expanded and launched the Boma International Hospitality College, with students enrolling for the Swiss Higher Diploma in Hotel Management, Diploma in Culinary Arts, and Diploma in Food and Beverage Operations.
The college's wealth of resources is what sets us apart and above from the rest. The college's exposure to the Boma Hotel, which is a 5-star hotel, and the Boma Inn, which is a four-star hotel, enable the students to learn in real time.
The impact of the 2010-2015 strategic plan, which just ended at the end of last year, was the cornerstone of that was to look at the whole issue of sustainability, the viability of the national organization. Investing in its people, which is core, investing in its staff and volunteers, investing in properties, in land, in businesses that would make the society sustainable and viable institution. And I think these were some of the major highlights. And we saw the building of the Boma brand of hotels that are today very well known in this country. It has also involved the setting up of the E-Plus or Emergency Ambulance Services. It was also setting up the Boma Hospitality International College. And other such like ventures. It also the highlights were also building properties and branch offices and regional meeting facilities, so that we really drove the whole idea of becoming self-sustaining, and this is what we really want to. Even in the new strategy, this is something that we wish to continue because it's a long journey, but we have taken the first few steps, and very good few steps.
As Kenya Red Cross Society celebrates 50 years of humanitarian work, it aims at being the most effective, trusted, and self-sustaining humanitarian organization, and continues to work with communities to prevent and alleviate human suffering and save lives of the most vulnerable.